Ah, it's good to be back. Welcome to General Hospital Envy, my GH after show. Let's get into it. Well, folks, we did it. Corona is still with us, but at least General Hospital is back, and it only took 3 months of Best of Sunny Corinthos episodes to get there, plus me reacting to some classic episodes on here. Thank you so much, by the way, for sending in all those requests. I had a blast strolling down memory lane with you guys. I'm not gonna lie, I really wasn't looking forward to going back into the world of Wily. Last we left off, it really looked like Nina was about to find out about Nell and that necklace at the trial, and that she was gonna go up to bat for her. Much to my relief, she didn't see the necklace, and Nina told the truth, that Nell is a compulsive liar, and that she blackmailed Julian into marrying her. And, of course, Nell couldn't help herself but to dig her own grave by freaking the F out, and I lived for it as much as Carly did. On top of that, Nell had the nerve to go to Nina's office and call her a lying traitor. And then, of course, she goes to Valentine after that and threatens to blow his secret of wanting to take over ELQ out of the water so that he'll help her again. And he does. Apparently, the writers thought that we enjoyed the whole Nell trying to kidnap Wily thing so much that we wanted to see it a second time. Writers, we are trying to move forward here. We have missed, 3 months of episodes. We don't want setbacks. We want movement, man. Here's an exciting turn of events. Dante Falconeri is back. I'm so excited. Now, I knew Dominic was returning. I don't know how long it was in the works for, but I didn't expect him to be the first person that we'd see in the first episode back. Now, the trial scenes were shot before the show shut down production, but these scenes with Dominic, they were shot afterwards, as you can see in this behind the scene photos, rocking the mask. Dante is clearly still struggling with some really bad PTSD, but since Dominic's return seems to be a permanent one, hopefully this means that he'll be back on the road to recovery in no time, and not a moment too soon, because Olivia is really struggling with him being gone, and Ned, he's not really being all that supportive of her. He's too busy focusing on ELQ and the possible takeover. I'm worried for them. This is really the first time they've had, trouble in paradise with this couple, and I really like them. Brooklyn actually found out that Valentine is actually behind the takeover of ELQ, leaving us wondering, will she help out the Quartermains, or will she throw them under the bus for a singing career that we will probably never actually see on screen? Spoiler alert, it's the second one. Okay, to be fair, Ned had a heart-to-heart with Brooklyn about how he'd secretly just rather do away with the company. You hear that? That's Edward Quartermain rolling in his grave. How convenient for the great and never-losing Valentine Cassadine. Anyways, next targets are Sam and Jason and the kids ELQ shares, and of course he knows all about Sam's parole situation, so he's totally gonna dangle that in her face to try to get her shares. Don't do it, Sam! I swear if you do it, I will be so mad! Now let's move on to Deception. Maxie, Lucy, and Sasha are still on a high from a very successful first photoshoot, and in Sasha's case, she's probably still high on some other things. But then, Valentine walks in with a new faced BLQ. It turns out that the actress who played Brooklyn was actually pregnant just before the show shut down, and 4 months have gone by, so she's probably, heavily pregnant now, and since we're in a pandemic, she probably didn't want to take the risk of going back on set, so I wish you the best of luck, Amanda. Now, after squabbling back and forth about Lulu, Maxie reluctantly agrees to let Brooklyn be the new voice of Deception. I wonder if we'll ever actually hear it. Okay, on to something that I really wish the writers would have just forgotten about. Before the show shut down, it really looked like Maxie might possibly be pregnant with Peter's child. They went with it, and Maxie has had 3 home pregnancy tests that all are positive. Can this just be the one time that it was false? Please, I do not want Maxie carrying that spawn. Peter is still a terrible person, okay? He had the nerve to write an article about Holly in his magazine, Holly's death, that he potentially caused himself. Robert attacked Peter for that article, rightfully so, and of course Anna jumped to Peter's defense. One thing is for certain, Robert needs to get to the bottom of the situation where, Holly is dead, but there's no body. Now, I don't actually remember if I mentioned this to you guys on the last episode of GH Envy, but if in case I didn't, or in case you guys forgot, Tristan Rogers actually confirmed that Emma Sams was actually supposed to return to the show as Holly, and that Robert and Holly would be a stable couple again. This was in the works. But then Emma Sams actually got COVID-19, and then shortly after that, production shut down, and now that they're back, no one really wants to travel to America currently. So, I mean, I don't really know where they're going to go with this story. They're clearly still telling it, but, you know, no one can really enter and no one probably wants to enter the US right now. I hope that one day Emma Sams does return to the show. I'd love to see Holly and Robert together again on screen. Anytime a legendary character from the glory days of the 80s General Hospital era can come back, I'm here for it. Speaking of legendary characters from the 80s, Mrs. Laura Collins is still at odds with the new big bad of Port Charles, Mr. Cyrus Renault. He is determined to get his hands on the hospital. Laura walked in on a very harsh conversation between Cyrus and Portia, who, by the way, I still don't trust as far as I can throw her. I think she's all up in the Cyrus mess. Anyway, Laura is determined to make sure that Cyrus doesn't get his hands on the hospital, so she goes over to Ned to try and get ELQ to fund the hospital once again so that Cyrus doesn't, which I'm pretty sure is going to blow up in her face once Valentine inevitably gets a hold of ELQ. Ugh. Seriously, why do the bad guys always have to win on the show? When will the good guys actually get the upper hand on something for once? It's so annoying. And Cyrus still has Jordan under his thumb too. She has to do his bidding, unless she wants one of her family members to die, basically. So she's screwed inevitably until Jason and Sunny do something. Sunny is going through hell with Mike right now. Mike is no longer eating, and Sunny had to debate whether or not to put him on a feeding tube. But thanks to Felix, he saw what Yvonne was going through with the feeding tube. I don't know if that's a good thing, because, you know, the whole doctor-patient confidentiality thing. But yeah, thanks to Felix, and also to Elizabeth with her heartfelt conversation with him, Sunny decides against it. Man, I gotta say that I actually feel really bad for Sunny in this situation. I can't imagine what it would be like to have to make that choice for your father, not knowing what he actually wants. Like, me and my mom were talking about it, and it was like, what would I do if my mom was in that state? What would she do if her mom was in that state? And it kind of made us have the conversation, you know, should we be figuring this kind of thing out, you know, while we're all still of sound in mind? And Jason, of course, had the same thought as we did. For some reason, though, Jason thought that it would be a good idea to give the power of attorney to Carly, and all the JSAM fans, including Carly herself, were like, huh? Essentially, his reasoning is that he wanted to spare Sam that pain of having to make that choice for him. So, you know, he gave it to Carly. And for some reason, he felt compelled, either 3 months or 2 days after he told her that he no longer wanted to see her in person anymore, depending on how you look at it, he thought that he should tell her that in person, and Sam was just like, okay, thanks. Pour some salt on the wounds, why don't you, Jason? I kind of feel like I'm forgetting something major when it comes to Sam. Oh right! She's been recast as well! Now relax, relax, it is a temporary recast. Kelly Monaco is already back on set filming new episodes, but in the meantime, Lindsay Hartley is taking over. It is a bit jarring, like, she's a good actress, but Sam, she plays the role so different. Like, I don't mind it, like, I think she's a great actress. And honestly, she's brought a lot more fire to Sam than Kelly Monaco has as of late. So I'm not totally complaining, but just the look and everything, it's so jarring. Anyway, I suppose it's a good thing that Jason was thinking about it, because not 2 seconds later, he ends up in a motorcycle accident. And the show is heavily implying that perhaps Brando is the reason he got into an accident. Jason's bike was in his shop. Cyrus and Brando had a conversation, seemingly about Jason, off screen. So they're heavily implying that he might have caused the accident. What do you guys think? Do you think Brando is behind it? Let me know in the comments below. Anyway, going back to Sam for a minute, earlier in the week she had a conversation with Alexis about what went down at the courthouse. Alexis pretty much figured out very fast that Julian was being blackmailed by Nell. Eventually the subject changes to Alexis and Neil's relationship, or lack thereof. She tells Sam that she has not informed Neil that she has been disbarred, and Sam decides to tell Neil for her. Neil shows up at the house to apologize, and Alexis is just like, I need some space. I guess the only other thing worth noting this week was that TJ was throwing himself into his work full throttle, and that Portia and Finn had a conversation about Violet maybe resenting Anna in the future for not actually being her real mom. Kind of left field, but I suppose it's a possibility. Truthfully, I don't have much to say on either subject, but that's GH. Honestly, it wasn't a bad first week back to General Hospital. I enjoyed it for the most part. The only thing I was really worried about was how obvious the social distancing would look, because I heard some things about Bold and the Beautiful, and I was really worried, because I heard things like, you know, split screens and mannequins and actor's spouse is stepping in for their character's significant others in love scenes, and I was just like, please don't let that be the future of GH. But honestly, you know, for the most part, it was really good. Now, obviously, some of the scenes that we saw this week were before the show shut down production, like the trial scenes, Nina and Nell's confrontation at the Crimson office, any of Brooklyn's scenes, but pretty much everything after that was brand new. And sometimes it was really obvious, you know, Michael's hair growing overnight, some of the makeup being dodgy on the first day. But in terms of the social distancing measures, I thought a lot of it was handled really well. There was a lot of subtle camera angles and tricks that they were doing. Some of it was obvious, like Sam and Alexa sitting on polar opposite sides of the couch, and same with Michael and Willow. But for the most part, they were actually having the characters stand in certain positions where it didn't seem as awkward because, you know, there's set pieces kind of in between them and it seems pretty natural. And they would have the actors kind of moving around the set so that they weren't in close proximity, but it made sense for the scene. So, you know, kudos to GH, and even also some of the camera angles when they would get a little bit closer, you could tell that they were probably far apart if you're thinking about it. But honestly, if I wasn't aware that we were in a pandemic and that social distancing measures were, you know, being put onto the show right now, I probably wouldn't have noticed. I thought they did a really good job. Although in some cases I am wondering the full behind the scenes situations, you know, are the actors having to get tested before they go in, because there are some scenes where the characters are holding hands, like Sunny and Carly, and I think Maxie and Lucy even at one point were high-fiving in a promo. You know, I could imagine there could be like hand sanitizer and things like that. I'm just curious. But anyway, all that aside, I'm just wanting the actors to be safe for entertaining us. You know, they're doing their jobs and they're making us happy. We've been GH-less for months and I'm glad they're back. I just want them to be safe, that's all. But anyway, what did you guys think of the show this week? Did you guys miss General Hospital? Let me know in the comments below what your highlights were. But if you liked this video, give it a big old thumbs up, subscribe if you want to, and I will see you guys next week. Peace out.